Hi, my name is Jessica Parsons, reporting for WHP News. Today, we will be taking a closer look at Tony and Tina's Wedding, the crazy, off-the-wall dinner theater performance that Western Michigan University is putting on this season. Americano, Americano, Americano. Se na Mexico, papa. Tu vuoi venire a posseda di mamma, tu vuoi fare Americano, Americano, Americano. Ma se nata in Italy, siendo me non c'è sta niente va. Hello, my name is Erica Ganaka, and I play Tina. This show is different from any other show because it's complete improv. There's free reign. There's lots of free reign for us. And it's, you know, a lot of audience interaction. So a lot of what we do is based on how the audience is, which is a little frightening.
My name is Rob Johnson. I'm a sophomore in the Western Michigan Theater Department. I play Tony, and Tony is the groom in the show. This show is different in a lot of reasons. I think one of the biggest ones is the fact that we interact with the audience. One thing for me is I really enjoy seeing the audience. Even when I'm in a proscenium show or a show that we're not supposed to break the fourth wall, I always enjoy peeking out and seeing how big they are. So for me, it's different because it's fulfilling. I get to see how big the audience is, how much fun they're having as we go.
It's different from most shows you'd see here in Michigan. It's an environmental piece of theater, so that means the minute you walk in the door, you're entering into a piece of theater, you know. The environment itself becomes the show, and the characters become a part of that environment and show itself. So you're completely immersed in what a wedding would be.
It's interesting because, you know, when you think of improv, you're always thinking about, you know, I have to do this and I have to do that. But really, when you're sitting there talking to people that are just eating food, you don't really have to think about anything because it's, you know, how do you converse in real life? It's the exact same thing with this show.
My interactions with the audience are always very interesting. I try to just be as much of a mom to them as well. Just it's 'cause I feel like a lot of the older audience members don't really know how to feel towards me because if they're like actually my age in real life, I feel like I have to work harder to be like that, but it's just fun to mess with people, you know.
I'm Mark Learman, Associate Professor of Theater at Western Michigan University, Director of Tony and Tina's Wedding.
Mark is awesome.
Mark's great.
Extremely supportive.
If anyone should do the show, it's Mark.
I was so excited when I knew that I was gonna get to work with him just because he has such a great reputation for pulling out such great work with all the actors that he works with. And I think that he did a really nice job of letting us develop how much we wanted to develop with our characters. He didn't push anything on us. It was all very like free range, and he would just guide us, you know, where what was working, what wasn't working, and different ideas.
One of the reasons that we chose to do this play was specifically because it would offer our actors a really new and different challenge.
Because there isn't a very strict script with particular lines, we have to develop a character from the ground up and live that character to be able to respond and speak to an audience. So everything's completely improv.
You know, we spend a lot of time in acting classes getting actors to prepare, to do their research, to do those kind of things. But the difference is in this one is that they would have to fully develop the characters first, because it all had to mesh. They all know each other. They're from the same neighborhood. They grew up together. They know the same story. So we spent a lot of time building background through doing improvs that were about their childhoods, about high school situations, about prom, whatever.
When we're at the union, it's very interesting because we had our characters and we knew exactly what to do in the open spaces. And it kind of actually helped us, I think, go into the show better. It's hard work. It's not like any other show.
Every night before the show, we had to set up all the tablecloths, the plates, the kitchenware, all that stuff. We'll probably spend another 30 or 45 minutes after the show breaking down literally everything and bringing it downstairs.
We're not essentially, you know, putting on a theater performance, we're putting on an event. It's more like coming to a themed dinner party.
Being crazy and hyper and partying every night. It's kind of just not really like, oh, we're going to do a show now. It's like, we're going to go party, so see you later. It's exhausting, but in the best of ways.
Ever since we had our first audience, been so blessed and so honored that it's worked out and that it's as fun as it is, and I'm having a blast. It's fun. It's a good time.